हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ अ वेरी गुड क्वेश्चन ऑफ एच सी वर्मा. कैपेसिटर टू कंडक्टिंग स्फीयर्स ऑफ रेडियस आर वन एंड आर टू आर केप्ट वाइडली सेपरेटेड फ्रॉम ईच अदर. ओके, दे आर वाइडली सेपरेटेड. इट मीन्स देयर विल नो इंट्रैक्शन बिटवीन दिस टू स्फीयर्स. फॉर द इंस्टेंट दे विल एक्ट एज अ आइसोलेटेड स्फीयर. फर्स्ट आई विल ड्रॉ अ स्फीयर and another sphere. They are very widely separated. It means the potential of this bigger sphere, I am giving the name R1, and the potential of this smaller sphere will not affect each other. There will be no interaction between these two spheres. They will act as isolated spheres. So for the first part, their capacitance will be just like a for an isolated sphere. So for capacitance for the bigger sphere, that is C1, will be equal to 4 pi epsilon naught R1. As we know, the capacitance of isolated sphere is 4 pi epsilon naught R1. So similarly, the capacitance of this capacitor, I am naming it as C2, will be equal to 4 pi epsilon naught R2. These are their individual capacitance when there is no interaction between these two spheres. After this, they are connected by a metallic wire. Okay, whenever we do connection by a metallic wire, the potential of two spheres will be same. This is an important concept. They seems to be in series, that the end to end, they are connected in end to end, but they are not in series, they are in parallel, because the potential of the surface of bigger and the potential of the surface of the smaller is same. Both are at same potential. When they are at both at same potential, let's name them the surface of this having potential V1. So the total potential will of this wire through this wire will be V1, and also of this will be V1. I will draw equivalent circuit diagram now again. This is V1, and the bigger sphere, this plate, and this is smaller, for smaller. The next potential, where will be the next potential? The next potential point will be at infinity, which is at zero. We will take the next potential point, which is at zero. So let's suppose this is second plate, and it is connected to the V infinity point. And this is a battery having the potential V. So I want to conclude that these two spheres are in parallel, not in series, because they having the same potential. So most of the student will take them as series connection, but they are not in series connection, they are in parallel connection. So the C equivalent will be C1 plus C2. So it will be 4 pi epsilon naught R1 plus 4 pi epsilon naught R2. So 4 pi epsilon 1 R1 plus 4 pi epsilon naught R2. This is a very simple question